Ranos here, and episode of Space Engineers. And today we're going to take up the fancy status display by Coffee and Ikura. Okay, no idea. The AR frames by Allright. The landing lights by Novar, and the desk console by Tomorrow Tech. So, since I'm standing right next to them, how about we do the AR frames first? First person. You can see, there's pretty much similar to a mod we did a couple days ago. Days? Weeks. But it uses more vanilla-like style. And it was made pretty much for the same reason. Because they wasn't too happy with the fact that I had the incomplete blocks to get the style. So they just made a mod that gives you one. And unlike the other one, these are flat panels too. I don't even color these things. I forgot to check. No, you can't. Can't color them, unfortunately, but oh well. And I think they're not too expensive on build cost. Nah, they're pretty cheap. Just a few construction components and girders. Yeah, not too bad. A big 2x2 one. And diagonal. So that's basically them. Use those for your like construction projects and all that kind of stuff. To add a bit more style, I guess. So anyway, how about we now move on to the desk console, which does require DLC. The one that gives you these desks and stuff. I think it's the first decoration DLC you needed for it. Yeah, basically adds two more variants. One has a chair and a terminal, and one that's just the terminal. With some clank hole. I think that model is actually from the small ship programmable block. Which that one is a programmable block. I wonder if I never checked if these are available on small ships or not. No. That's unfortunate. Everything here is a large ship block only. Yeah, this one acts like a seat. Like a control seat. As you can see. Can't wait for it to let you control the ship with this thing. So it has no controls for it. Unless you're using WASD and stuff like that. It'd be kind of weird to control a ship in real life like that, wouldn't it? Anyhoodle. What's the build cost? Yeah, just a few more displays, computers. Wait, why does that need 100 computers? That only needs 2. Because this one is a programmable block. Wait, dare I say that? I remember. But yeah, you can add scripts and stuff to this one. It's handy. They might actually replace all the desk on the Earth Eater Mark II with these. Because I'm currently using a different mod where they're just passenger seats. This one actually gives them a bit more function. And a workable display. Well, anyway, that's just them. Now how about we move on to the landing lights. And see, you get well, pretty much any colour you want. The default is blue, but you change it to green or red. And the direction the lights are going and how far they go and the size of the lights can be adjusted. Because if we head down here, go into here and go light. See, you choose the colour, choose the diameter of the lights, and choose the spacing between them. But there are always 10 lights. So if I have to go here and turn this one to 1, and turn this one to 2, also the direction determines which way the lights are going. If it's unchecked, it goes outwards. If it is checked, it goes inwards. Let's shrink the diameter a bit too. And a bump. And see, they are now much closer to each other. And they no longer stretch all the way over there. Which can be handy. Yeah, the numbers indicates how many blocks are in between them. Well, and including the blocks that are on themselves. You get one there, then you get one there, one there. See, this one has one block in between. As you can see. No, not really, because of the sun. I'm going to see better this way. And there we go. You can see those line up. They're not exactly synced. So I'm guessing the only way to get them to sync up is to turn them off and back on. But yeah. This way you'll be able to make pathways for ships to land and depart. As a way to guide them into the hangar. As for their build cost. Indeed, damn it. It's just... Oh, okay. It's about 21 steel, 1 motor, 2 computers, 2 live steel tubes, and 4 construction components. So it's not really all that expensive. It's pretty handy, and since you can have whatever colour you want, you can have all sorts of different purposes. Ooh, you can even do some sort of the light display if you wanted to. That would be quite difficult to set up, but it could be interesting. You know, like have like 4 of them facing 4 different directions and they all just go in different colours and stuff. I wonder if it's possible to make a script that will change its colour random. So you can have it going rainbow coloured. Probably. That should be interesting to see. But it's not something I can set up. So anyway, how about we take a look at the last one? Which is the fancy status displays. Which isn't a mod. So you can go into any world, regardless if it has mods or not, and you can use this script. It's similar in style to the automatic LCD2 script, but as you can see, it's more visual. But it is also a lot more limited. It can't do as much, as in it can't show you what's in a container or a refiner or assembler. But it can give you percentages and how much power is going in or out, and how full an inventory is. As you can see with these bottom ones. These is the input slots of the refineries, that's the input of the assemblers, that's meant to be the output of the assemblers as well. Because there's the option for batteries, reactors, hydrogen engines, refineries, and assemblers. Unfortunately, I don't have it working right now. The key code needed to get it working isn't listed in the guide. For some reason, that, or I didn't see it. Probably didn't see it. I wonder if there's actually... Nah, don't really know where it is. Oh well, no matter. There's all sorts of different tags you can do. Like some that gets rid of the headline, header, which is this part at the top. Some that makes the bar wide. Like just one of these block bars that goes all the way across. Which, if I go show you with the refineries over here, still need to finish that control tower. And... See, that's the wide one. There's also a small version of it. We go here. I'm not sure if that needs to be big or not. Now it's small, but well, 2 of them on that one now. I only left it as 1 mainly because of the fact that it's only in front of one of the refineries. But if you're small, you can have like a bunch of them on a single screen. I wonder how much you can actually fit on a normal LCD. That would be interesting to find out. Yeah, put that one there because I got to put more stuff on it, but I kind of didn't. Oops. So these are the batteries. These are solar panels. So these are, like, that shows how much power they have, and that shows the output of the solar panels. So it does the same for the refineries. No, I already said refineries. The reactors and hydrogen engines. And now, it shows the fill rate of the fuel inventory. In other words, how much fuel they have is what it will display for those ones. There aren't any of those two on this base, so I can't really display them. But their optional feature, let's just go through the optional features of all of them. For batteries, it will show the charge state of the battery in the normal state. The optional will show the power input and output of the batteries. For the reactors and hydrogen engines, I already mentioned they show the inventory level of the fuel inventory, but the optional is relative power output for both of them, percentage of power load, in other words, how much of their max capacity is being used. For refineries, it's the fill rate of the refinery's inventory, input inventory, and its option is the fill rate of the output inventory. Like, to have both of those set up so you have one that shows how much ore is going in and how much ingots is coming out. But if you've got a system like mine where it's all automatically going in and out really quickly, here is it isn't of much use. But I guess the fill one is, so you know how much ore is in them. So you know if they're actually doing anything or not. Because it's at zero, it means they're not doing anything. And the assembler shows the fill rate of the input inventory and number of items in the production queue. As you can see at the end over there. But the option is the fill rate of the output inventory and the completion rate of the current item in queue. Which you can see, it's not really showing up like that. The same assembler can't have both 40% in the output and input. Well, it can, but it doesn't in this particular situation. I'll show you. No, wait, wouldn't it be easier just to go to production? I'll show you just input and output anyway. You can see, that's what's called as input. Yeah, that is. I think I might have done something wrong here. Yeah, let's go to number one. Inventory screen would have been better. Oh, I messed up. It is showing the output. So simply putting down optional will show the other stat. What is it? I think I'm on one. This is the input, and that's the output. Nah, can't be. Okay. Huh. Why is it showing assembly 2 of anything? Why is this? Hydro cannot pass through small conveyors. Okay. Don't know why I need to mark that there. Kind of confused why all the others aren't showing any percentage. Strange. Ah. So yeah, I messed up the code. My mistake. So let's see if we can fix that. So we put that there. That should fix it. No. Oopsie. I just got them on the same one. I'm showing the exact same thing. Frick. I just want to have this whole thing figured out. I guess not. No change. So yeah. I'm not sure why it's not really working. I'm not sure what I've done wrong, it's just that the keywords aren't shown on the guide. Pretty sure it would just be optional since that's what it shows. Oh well, never mind. Also, it has unique icons for the drills, grinders, and welders. I forgot what his name was. Hey. They'd be able to see how full their inventory is. Although, do they have any other features? Nah, they wouldn't do. The only thing they need is how full the inventory is. So anyway, I'm going to have links for all four mods, well, three mods and a script, in the description below. And I hope you've all enjoyed this video. If you have, please leave a like and even subscribe for more episodes. And I shall see you all next time. Bye-bye. We'll be right back.